Hi Tango Dancer, in this video we are going to share with you a secret that my grandfather, who was a milonguero, told me once, and it's something that you know, you can apply in your tango as well, and it's something that you cannot learn anywhere if you don't have a grandfather that is a milonguero.
It has to do with the essence of tango dancing and how it was meant to be listened to and danced to. Hi, we are Pablo and Anne from Tango Space, where we help men and women to move better, express themselves, become more creative and more elegant with our tango lessons. In this video, we do want to share a secret of musicality with you that comes straight from Pablo's grandfather.
Yes, my grandfather was a milonguero. He used to dance every night, you know, all his life. So the only thing that he did was really dancing. He was not a professional dancer. He was just a milonguero, a social dancer. And yes, I grew up with him. So I remember, you know, always to see him, you know, getting ready for the milonga in the afternoon, you know, in the patio outside of the house, cleaning his shoes and getting ready for the milonga. And yeah, he will come back, you know, at early hours in the morning after the milonga. And yes, his life was all about dancing, about tango. So that's why all I learned from him, I like to share with you, because I think it's these people that they really grow up with tango and they dance all their life. So I think that always that they have a lot to share with us. And I was lucky to absorb all this, so now we can share with you. So the little secret that we want to share with you is about the musicality, it's about dancing to the singer. Yes, we always in our musicality classes, in our musicality online course as well, we encourage dancers to listen to the singers, because it's, you know, it's something that we do in Argentina, that milongueros and tango people in Argentina do, is dancing to the singers. So the story is this one, that my grandfather say that each singer has a different character, different voices, different ways to sing. It's not about the lyrics. Of course, if you understand the lyrics, it will also help you, but it's not about understanding the lyrics, if not understanding the quality of the voice. And when the singer talks, he always say, you shouldn't dance. Yes, if somebody is talking to you, you have to give the attention and not doing things. Yes, if somebody's talking to you, you stop and you listen. Yes, so he always said that there is these moments in many tangos that the singer is talking, is not singing, and it's a really, really special moment, very, very deep moment for you to create something nice with your partner, and something small, yes, something, a pose or something, that you stop moving, you stop, you know, whatever you were doing, you stop and you listen and you try to share that deep moment with your partner.
And you used to say that your grandfather used to call the singer his friends.
Yes, so my grandfather has, you know, he was so much into tango music that when he will talk about Verón, about, you know, all the singers of the tango music, Maure, Chahue, he will talk like he was talking about his friends, you know. He was so into it that he always, you know, say, you know, that each singer is completely different, having different friends, you know, and they are different, so we are going to dance in a different way.
So now we are going to dance a part of a song where there is the singer speaking. You will see it is quite common, and you see we will really change our physicality to pay attention to what he is saying to us.
So we are going to dance now to the tango that is called Passional by the orchestra of Osvaldo Pugliese. So let's have a look at this.
Se vida de mí. así te siento, solo mía, siempre mía. Tengo miedo de perderte, de pensar en no darte. Porque es otra brutal, porque me habré de sangrar si en cada beso te siento llorar. Sin embargo, me atormento. Tus labios besar, tus manos besan, caricias que me atan a tus encantos de mujer.
As you could see, we really slowed down when with the singer, when the singer was talking. This singer is Alberto Morán. We love this singer with the orchestra of Osvaldo Pugliese. And yes, what you want is to do less. Yeah? So we always we say to feel more the music, you have to do less in a way. And mm-hmm. that's these moments where you really want to be, you know, engaged with the music and with the singer. And yes, when the singer is talking, you want to pause, you know, you want to relax and to prepare, you know, for the next moment, but enjoying that moment with your partner.
And followers, you really want to develop your musicality as well and be aware of those little moments in the dance. You could simply, if your partner is not hearing that, slow down and you will see it is going to influence his musicality. So your way of listening to the music really matters. You want to be a great musical dancer in order to be able to influence your partner.
Yes, and this kind of thing, because we always say, we say, yeah, you have to feel the music. We say in tango, you have to feel the music, and always students ask, but how I feel the music? So this is one of the things. This is one of the elements that you have to start applying, to start connecting more with the music, to feel, you know, what the orchestra and the singer want to express with the music. So now the question is, are you going to apply this in your tango dancing? Are you going to start listening to the singer and pausing and dancing when the singer is talking?
Yes, we'd love to know. Please let us know in the comments below. And if you want to go deeper with us on the musicality, we have a free musicality mini course where we go into the fundamental elements of musicality with you. So we will put the link in the comments. Make sure you click on the link and join us there.
Please, if you like this video, please like it and share it with your friends.
If you're on YouTube, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and hit the notification bell so that you are notified every time we release a new video. We share weekly video tips that will help make your tango dancing more elegant, more connected, more musical. And especially,
please keep learning and keep sharing your dancing, because the world of tango needs your embrace.
Yes, definitely. Thank you so much for watching, and we look forward to seeing you in the next video.
Bye.
Bye.